Appreciate it. I'll zoom through this. I hope you can't hear the dogs behind me.
All good.
The natives are getting restless in the backyard or something like that. But guys, man, connected with Drew a little bit, teaching me how to do some presentation stuff with Run the Power and kind of helping me out during huddle stuff. So, man, honored to be on here and show you guys. What I want to talk about tonight is, let me share my desktop with you real quick and get into this. I think it's helped us out. And, you know, a lot of coaches say that, can you see it? Are we good?
Yep, you're good.
Okay, awesome. A lot of people say that, hey, we're a tempo team. And 2 years ago, we were looking at, or say 3 years ago, so we're 2 years into simplifying how we do our play calls, how we do practice. And I think it's been a game changer for us, as you'll see as we go through. And then for us, we took, and our motto's to the top, as you'll see as we go through, and we took the top as time of possession. And we wanted to make it total offensive plays. So simple one-word play calls that we use. John Weaver, I'm the wide receiver coach at MRA. We won the state championship this past year. Through our quarterback threw for 593 in the championship game. It was a fun night to be a receiver coach because that ball was in the air. So let me show you how this works and why we went to it. We wanted to maximize practice time. So we don't have five-minute periods. We use four-minute periods. And I think those are awesome. One, it allows us to coach faster and talk faster. So I think this 15-minute presentation is going to be a breeze for me. It eliminates wordy plays. So you got to communicate effectively. And it really didn't matter what we know. It's what the kids know. So all these words and, like, these NFL play calls that you hear, I get it why they do it. But if I was an NFL quarterback, I'll tell you, I couldn't remember all that stuff. So I remember on Sundays I'll watch and I'm like, man, I can't remember all that stuff. And I'm hearing like three times. That's why the XFL was so cool. You'd hear June Jones call out something that was so simple. It's easy to remember. And then it's reps, reps, reps. So I put this picture of this construction guys because how many times does your play sheet or you see people with their play sheet and you got to have three people to unfold it and that's what it looks like because it's so long and how long these words are. Well, for us, we don't really care what the word is as long as the kids know the signal. So the biggest obstacle for us when we started looking at this, how can we get our play calls in faster? Well, let's have hand signals that are that work and operate having one word with one signal and we roll it. And I think that's been beneficial for us because as you see, I'll show you what we used to have and then what we went to and how it changes things. So that's how it works. You want to maximize the practice time. And in maximizing our practice time, a couple of college guys have come out and saw us practice and we will use our headsets. So they're just not a Friday night gig. We use them every day. We have two signalers signaling every day at practice. So I'm on the field coaching the receivers. The O-line coach is behind them coaching the O-line. The head coach, who's our – Herbert Davis is our OC as well. And he's behind the whole offense, and he's calling plays. And then the more I thought about it, I was like, it really doesn't matter what these kids know because we're nonverbal all the way through. It's a matter of what we signal to them. So you could call it Timbuktu, and they're like, what play is that? And you show them a signal, they'll know exactly what that means. So, disclaimer, there's no such thing as a perfect play, coaches. We were a big check with me, and you got to get that perfect play. And we've just come to the conclusion of let your kids make it right. Yeah, they're gonna mess up, but let the kids practice what you've done all week and let them allow them to play at a high level because you've practiced that high level. So for us, when we're doing our tempo period, and I'll show you what that looks like. And I'll tell you what tempo is first before I get into that. It's the ability to operate at the speed you want to. And a lot of people think, oh, tempo, we go fast. Well, we were up by 21 points at the end of the championship game and wanted to run out the clock. People were like, oh, a tempo team, how do you slow it down? Well, for tempo for us is you can either be the Roadrunner or you can be the Wile E. Coyote. It really doesn't matter. It's what you describe as tempo. Do you want to go fast? Well, then we can amp it up. Do you want to go and slow it down? Absolutely. So we've had, you know, teams have like Nike mode, NASCAR mode to go fast. I've been in systems where they have an okay system to where we're going to slow down everything. But for us, when we go through this, our practice plan is what makes this thing go. And we went to the 4 minute periods. And also, we never go in full pads. and I don't want to say we're a feed the cat team because we're not, we don't use that, that verbiage or anything like that, but we're in shells 99% of the time. And the biggest thing that went for us is team takeoff. And with team takeoff, we're going through our plays. So if a kid messes up a play, we're going and trying to get in plays as fast as we can. And that allows us to play faster, if that makes sense. So we're going to film everything, much like a lot of you guys do. And then we're going to take it and we're going to flip it and say, hey, we'll go back and correct it and film, but we want to run as many plays as we can. So we went and looked, and in an 8-minute period, and when you see these hammer down periods, that's where we're amping it up, O versus D, and team takeoff is versus air. So we're going through our script, and in 8 minutes, I think we went through 23 plays, and in a 4-minute period, I think we went through 13 or 12 plays at one time, just going. And if you want to be fast on Friday or Saturday, if you're a college coach, or even Thursday night, you got to practice fast. I've been on staffs to say, hey, we're a tempo team, and practice isn't going very fast. So don't expect Friday night to be fast if you're not fast Monday through Thursday. So what we do here, and I'll show you how we practice, then I'll go into our play calls. But we do a blitz pickup, and our team takeoff is an 8-minute deal. Our hammer downs, whenever the kids see hammer down, it is full tilt, 100 miles an hour. And the way we do that is simplifying our play calling. Okay, so here's why we did it. Ability to play faster, ability to combine our best runs and our routes together. So RPOs in one word. And then we have signals that go with that. So we don't have these like the signal trips and or strong or weak or whatever your doubles is. We have all this in one word. So formation, run, RPO, protection, you name it, is one word. And a little funny thing, I was talking to our head coach today. I was like, do you realize we created a play, a one-word play at halftime in the first time when we played prep, the team we played in the championship game, and just made it up. Kids remembered it, and they go, because you got to think about this. Kids remember stuff. And the way we went to this is, if you think about kids and you teach them, that they remember definitions by one words, like words that associate with that word inside the definition. So it works for us for that. So let's go old play. Gun Brown right, zone 2 Monday. Holy cow, right? Try to signal that in on Friday night. The new play is just saw. It's inside zone. Old play. Open trips, right, red, 324 fish. That tells everybody what to do, how you're doing it. The new play, just call it floss. And I'll show you some cut-ups of how we do this. Now, huddle doesn't allow you to show you how you play fast because it cuts it up. And then example of this, so you can add the run and the RPO. Gun Brown right, zone right, 324 fish. Well, it's saw floss. And it's two words, but we have one signal. And that tells us protection, that tells us a run, and that tells us an RPO. We also have them if you just want to take a shot. That puts them in formation, protection, and a play. I think that's big when things that you want to do. Let me go into I got some huddle clips of us real quick, just calling these plays. So here's flick. And a lot like what Jason was talking about, we do the same thing. We throw the gift. So down here you'll see the gift. But we're playing so fast, they can't even line up. And we're just throwing that out there. One word, protection. So there's flick again. I'll show you some other ones. And all we do is we blended words. So you're thinking, what's floss? Well, one word tells our guys all what to do. So flat out here and slants here. And we make it floss. If you go back to flick, it's a flat out and a old stick concept. But you'll see it here. You'll run slants to the field right here. And what helps us is our kids know we're field boundary. I think the simpler you make it, the faster you can go. So we're always going to put trips, because a lot of times you want to put trips right. Well, if you think about it, on Friday night, you're putting trips to the field probably 95, 97% of the time. So we just call trips and we tell our receivers to go to the field. We have a different call if we want to put them in the boundary. So that allows them to play fast. They see the signal and they go. Here's Hick. Hitch to the boundary, stick concept to the field, hick. We just signal hick, they see it, and we're rolling. We have some fun competitions in practice to see who can get lined up faster, the O-linemen or the receivers. Here it is again, haul, so it's hitches and slants. That's with our babies in here. Look, another concept. One word tells all four, protection, everything. Let me go to these. Halo, this is probably one of my favorite plays here. We do it as word association. So this is, everybody was starting to take away our stick route right here. And this guy was ice cream trucking. Like he was like a kid running to an ice cream truck. Like they just, they haul, like my kid saw a snow cone machine today and they busted out the house. Watch this backer want to go and rob this old stick route right here, this flat out. We got a little surprise for him right here. We'll just bend it right back in. And we made that change in one day. We're like, hey, let's take this. And we saw LSU run the little benders across the middle that everybody was doing, that they were doing and getting money out of that. And we're like, hey, we can do that. Just tag the H and Halo. Hey, boundary guys, you still run the hitch. We just changed this. Run the hitch. Change one guy. And did that there. And go back to that. Let me go back to the PowerPoint if I can find it. Here it is. How much time I got left?
I don't know. You're good. You got a couple questions here. You want to answer one while you're looking?
Yeah, go ahead. Go ahead.
So Gum wants to know, what do you guys do during your break in practice? What does that look like?
A break? Depends on how good we went through hammer down, essentially. So if it was a good hammer down, he'll tell him to take a break. But we're big on giving him a break. Our kids like going fast. They talk fast. I mean, hell, I'm talking fast right now. And one because I got 15 minutes, but we give them a break. I mean, a break is a break for them. So helmets off and all that, but you got to think, we're not in full gear. We're in shorts and shoulder pads and helmet. And that allows us to play fast because we want to be fast on Friday nights.
And then during your hammer down period, you guys have two huddles going or you just roll with one?
You know, we've toyed with two. We have toyed with two. In the summer, we will, because we want to get get maximum reps. And then during the other times, we'll just do one. We'll just do one. Come on, buddy. We'll just do one and be done with that.
And then during your four-minute segment, do you guys use a segment clock to work during practice? No. Or do you guys have someone time it?
That's a great question. And if you guys want this – we have a four-minute beeper timer that we made. And we used to have the clock, and everybody would, you know, the clock would – you'd miss the clock, or you're coaching, and you're like, oh, I'm in this period. It wasn't very loud. So we hooked up music and the beeper system to practice. So it is – it is loud. It sounds like an old foghorn, like, period one. And everybody hears it, and we're rocking and rolling. So – if you want that, I have a four-minute period, and I think I have a five-minute period one too. If you want it, I got all my contact info on here. If you want it, I'll email it to you. So it's just – it helped us out, Drew, yep. When we were doing all that stuff. Like, how can we make it simple for us, easy for us? So we include headsets. We include the music. And look, all the music's fast. We're not playing any Southern country stuff. I mean, it is amped up. Linkin Park, I mean, you name it.
How many one word concepts do you guys carry into a game?
12.
And then, 12. Do you start by, so do you guys teach the full play call first and then teach the one word play, or do you just start right from
the
one word?
Nope. Why teach them the whole thing? We're just going to tell them, hey, this word means this, and that's all it means. Yep. That's why we're able to change them. I mean, we literally changed one at halftime. Said, hey, what we call this week, that's off. We're going to switch it to this, and that's it. They don't need to know what everybody else is doing. They know field boundary. They know what the protection is. They know what formation we're in. And team takeoff is where we'll start doing those plays. So they'll learn them on Monday. So we go Monday morning for about an hour and 15. We'll go Monday afternoon for a light little workout, and then we'll go Tuesday, Wednesday will be no helmet. I mean, we might as well be in tennis shoes on Wednesday. Then we go Thursday morning for about an hour, 15, hour and a half, and we're done. We're off the field by 7:45 on Thursday mornings for a Friday game at 7 o'clock. Just the old Chip Kelly thing where you want to recover the body. You want that 24 hours recovery. And it's been beneficial for us.
Nice.
I mean, we went, I think there's one game, I think we snapped it 72 times, 73 times. I mean, we were rocking and rolling. We called nothing, but we played a 5A big public school in the spring last year and called nothing but our one-word plays and gassed them out. Like, they were done. That's all we called in the spring. Like, nothing else. Our kids were just like, one word, one word, one word, and that's how we kind of trained them up on it.
Nice.
Any other questions?
That's it for your questions. You got anything
else? All right, guys. Yeah, I'm big on culture. The Clarion Ledger, one of our state newspapers, saw us. And I think it's important, just as much as the one-word plays and how we practice, of having a unit identity. Disclaimer, I love Top Gun. I love everything about it. F-16s are awesome. And so my guys have call signs. And they did a little two-minute clip I wanted to show you guys about unit identity, if you don't mind. And just go with that. And our call sign, I say, or cliche, is take flight. Identities within teams are a huge thing. And this is nothing really new. You know, if you think back to the Purple People Eaters with Minnesota Vikings, the Orange Crush with the Denver Broncos, I knew that there was a sense of identity that you needed within position groups, within a football program. And with us throwing the ball, we needed to have something fun. So we came up with, like, Money Crew was one of them. Flight School was another one, I believe. And we really couldn't decide on one until I started thinking about Air Raid and the offense that we run. And we throw the ball a lot, and we have an awesome quarterback with Phillip. And I was like, you know that. And then I thought about my dad's in the military, and I was like, what about Brigade? And I was like, that's a subunit of the Army and all that. So I was like, that's kind of what we are with our football team. And that, it kind of stuck.
I'm Tyler Starnes. My call sign is T-Bone.
Call sign is Spider.
I'm Landon Fulcher. My call sign is Suave.
Smooth. My J-Do. So first and last name.
We wanted to be, I don't want to say set apart from the team, but a subunit of the team where our guys, I challenge them daily to make plays. And I think they thought, well, he's not going to write notes every game for us. And it's turned into, I mean, Russ, I just saw he's had everyone from last year. And, you know, I love my players. And I think that's one way to show that you love and that you care. I mean, football is the vehicle that drives what we do for a living.
I think it's really inspiring. I think it's nice for him to do that, especially, you know, before real big games, just to tell us how great we've been. And, it's actually something you want to read before a game just because you're real nervous or, like, your mind's racing. But just to see, like, you know, there's no pressure and just go out there and play.
I think it gives, like, a sense of confidence for the game, knowing that he took his time out to write that, that he trusts us, and that we all trust each other to do what we're supposed to do and get the job done.
You know, there are just so many things in life that football is just a small part of it. And if we can take a time to write a handwritten note, to get a badge, to come up with a cool call sign, to have them part of a unit and an identity in their high school career, I think that speaks volumes for what our sports are going to now. Thanks, guys, for that. Oh, let me go to that. And then if you have any other questions, this is my Twitter, at Coach Weaver MRA. That's my email, jweaver@mrapats.org. And then this is my cell, 601-218-3943. If you want that beeper system, if you want to know more about our one-word plays, I'd love to talk to you about it. If you want to talk about unit identity and what we do inside the Air Raid Brigade, this is you going into year three, and our guys love it. You know, it started out being cheesy, and they're probably going to think it's cheesy when you start something like that. But in the end of the day, T-Bone said the one thing right there, it was trust, and it builds trust within those players.
Sweet. Thanks, Coach. Appreciate it,
absolutely,
man.
Absolutely. Yeah.